Well, hey, folks, how's it all going? And oh, man, what are you going to do today? Yeah, I read the description, folks. We're going to do some Caribbean-style jerk porterhouse pork chops, folks. And we're going to do, you know what? I'm going to show you how it's super simple to do, folks. And we're going to get some smoke using indirect on the Weber Go Anywhere charcoal. And then we're going to give them a quick sear. And where else would you go for a quick sear? But when you got something that goes 1,500 degrees, folks, that's what you're going to do for a quick sear. So we're going to use the Weber Go Anywhere with the Caveman, and it's going to be awesome. I'll tell you what, let's go take a look. Go take a look at those pork chops while we get this thing fired up. All right, folks, let's take a look at what we got here. We got some pork chops, some nice porterhouse pork chops. They're about an inch thick. Nice. So I always try and keep things simple for you, and I can always go very exotic, but I try and keep stuff that's available nationwide, and this is what this Lori's Caribbean jerk is. And now this Lori's, they do have non-salt and MSG free, because this stuff is pretty high in salt. I can only imagine what's in there. So we're gonna put it in a Ziploc bag, 30 minutes, and then put some smoke on that wherever go anywhere. Stay tuned. All right, folks, there's our Caribbean jerk style pork chops in the marinade, and just keep on turning it around there, had it in the fridge. We're right around that 30 minute mark. So we're gonna get this on next time you see it. It's be on the way we're going anywhere indirect. And you know what? So once we get it on there, I'll give you this look, see at the setup. All right, folks, we just got those porterhouse pork chops on. Oh man, I'm getting hungry. Yeah, so let's look at the setup. So indirect is what we're doing here. So you can see top vent's closed on that side. That's the charcoal side. The bottom vent is open. That lets the air come in, and then it circulates over to the top vent over here on the meat side, and the bottom vent is closed over there. So let's take a quick look. Got three little pieces of hickory in there, and you can see, oh man, we got our marinated pork in there. 110 is what we're gonna take this up to, maybe even a little less, and then we're gonna get it seared. Remember, when you're cooking it, searing at 1500 degrees, that's probably not gonna be less than a minute per side. So you know what, when we come back, we'll be searing. Stay tuned for that. All right, folks, here we go. Ain't gonna take long. I said these things are right around 110. Top shelf. Give her a minute or so, not even that, and then we'll flip them. Stay tuned. That ain't more than 15 seconds. Look at that. Any question whether that's 1500 degrees? I think it is. 10 more seconds, take it off, give it a flip. All right, so after about 45 seconds, gave it a flip, and this is the other side. I'll give you a look-see as that proceeds. All right, let's take a look. About 35 seconds, maybe. Oh my gosh. That is done. Those are pork chops seared on the Caveman. That thing is awesome. I'll tell you what, give you a look-see once they're plated up. Oh man. We look at that, there's that Cajun jerk pork chops, porterhouse pork chops, folks. Oh, take a little taste test here. Definitely done. Oh man, folks. Can really taste that seasoning. A little bit of smoke in there. Tom Horseman on YouTube. Thumbs up, leave a comment. And as always, folks, can't say it enough. Thanks for watching. I do appreciate it.